Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day in the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great week, folks. Let's take a look at one of our four agreements. Be impeccable with your word. Release the need to be right. When you believe something, you assume you're right. You may even destroy relationships in order to defend your position. Let go of the need to defend your position. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials right now trading up 222 bucks. NASDAQ is up 9. S&P's up 20. Gold contract down $15.20 trading. Excuse me, folks. 1931, silver down 29 cents, $26.44 an ounce. Light sweet crude up 9 cents, $42.43 a barrel, notes and bonds. 10-year right now, down 2 ticks, 139.16. The 30-year off 8 at 179.11 in King Dollar. King Dollar's up 70 ticks, trading 93.318. The euro is at 117. The yen is at 105.97. The British pound's at 130 to 1 US dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. Now, in the world of the NASDAQ, folks, this is the only one that, we'll see how this shakes out. We've had Apple get up to a price point today of 515. We're at 500 right now, bottom line. Going to be wild watching this come into the close. The reason being is that this is the last day that you can actually own Apple on record, and then you get the split. So the real kicker here on Apple is going to be, you know, the bottom line is that do you want the stock, the folks that are in it, do they want the stock, or do they want less of the stock, or do they want more of the stock as this comes into the close? So we'll see how this baby's going to shake out, but I expect you're going to see a little volatility out here. S&Ps. We take a look at the S&Ps, the bottom line, you get a higher high. Yes, the volume is still contracting. There's no two ways about that. Bottom line, 29 million shares out here. Friday, you end up doing 55 million. At highs like these, folks, you should be up somewhere about 150 million, something like that. Bottom line, though, it's not. And they keep driving it in price. Gold contract out here. We had with gold. Gold closed out the day. Well, at the pit trading, we're at 1931 right now. We had a high out here of 1970. And you get volume out here of 277,000 contracts. So you get decent contract volume. What we did last week inside the gold market is this. We had come down a week ago, 2 weeks ago tomorrow, hard and fast, man. We came down from the 2040 to 1911. You did it with 565,000 contracts, big contract volume. We did a bounce. The next day, folks, what we had done is this. You got under the lows, you rejected lower price, and you had lighter volume. Now, that's what you need to get to higher price. Next day, we got down to 1874. You did volume of 460. Then we bounced, had a nice bounce. We went from 1874 all the way up to 2024. Then we came right back down and tested again, and that's what I always like to see. Why? Because the more tests that you actually get, you're getting more information. It's giving you more confirmation that you don't have a huge amount of sellers when you're trying to test lows. Bottom line, we got that last Wednesday. We came down with the 443,000, you know, going into that 568. So bottom line, right now, we're still building cars. And my take is that we're building cars to get to the 2,700 level inside of gold. We're going to take a look at the silver market. Silver's set up the exact same way as gold. Different numbers, of course, because you're talking about just, you know, in the thousands versus $26. That being said, silver is actually shown that it's actually stronger than gold right now. We did with the silver market. Silver went hard and fast from $29 to $24, tested $23.50, rejected it, gets all the way up to the $28, and that was pushing with big volume, and now you're contracting with volume once again. Silver looks to me like we're going to make that run to $35. Last high in silver was up there at $30. Bottom line, $35 is the bigger picture inside silver. Now, let's go to the dollar, because what you have here is that the numbers that I'm giving you, I wouldn't be seeing those numbers. We wouldn't be seeing those numbers. Of course, we're in the speculation business. If, in fact, that dollar didn't get into lower price. So what do we have? Dollar had come down hard. We busted out the lows last week. As you busted out the lows, guess what? Jumped right back inside the higher range. And my take is that we're going to go after these swing points from the 3rd as well as the 12th of August. And we'll see what ends up happening up at that point. The bottom line is that right now we're at the 93,326. And we're talking about 93,991, 93,905. Those are the two numbers. And this has been the weakest dead cat bounce I've seen in a long period of time. There's no doubt about that. Bottom line, we'll see whether they take those numbers out. Because inside the dollar, folks, if you did take those numbers out, you know, the dollar can bounce a lot further than this. And if this was a normal market, I'd say, hey, man, the dollar can bounce at 95.76. That's what normally happens when you have such a breakdown as we have had inside of the dollar. But bottom line, what has happened is that the last two bounces inside of the dollar haven't even done, just barely have done a 0.27. And a 0.382 is a dead cat bounce. So going to be wild. Tesla, bottom line is that that baby got up into the 2200s, I think, today. Let me look at this. What you had with Tesla out here, 2129, and then sold off after 2129. What Tesla did get going out here today, there's a couple stories out here about their Model 3s, and they're great stories for a Tesla, because the bottom line is that in the used car market, folks, most of these electronic vehicles haven't held up. Well, the Tesla Model 3, which they're hard to find anyway, holding up in an extraordinary way, meaning people are paying big dollars for them. The depreciation doesn't come down. If you just Google Tesla or the Bloomberg article, you'll see it's pretty cool, man. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.